My name is Dr. Dan Eastow. I'm the course leader for the Masters in Applied Sports Science. I'm also a senior lecturer in biomechanics for the Institute of Sport and Exercise Science. The Applied Sports Science Masters course at the University of Worcester is specifically designed for not only students coming from their undergraduate studies, but also students who are actually working in the industry in various fields. The course is set up so that it has intensive periods of study, two intensive one-week blocks throughout the year, and this is then supported by distance learning methods, utilisation of virtual learning environments such as Blackboard, to support students through their studies with additional tutorials from staff. The basic design of the course is so that students can continue working in the industry or working with athletes or other individuals in the sport and exercise science field whilst completing their masters either on a full-time or part-time basis. The university is going from strength to strength. The extension in facilities and campuses is ongoing, and particularly from a sports and exercise science viewpoint, the facilities really are second to none. We've got a brand new sports arena that was finished last year, which is a 3 basketball court size, and an additional strength and conditioning suite that's part of the institute. This is in addition to the other facilities we have on the St John's campus with regards to the sports centre, physiology and biomechanics labs that have been here for a number of years now. Essentially, for studying sport and exercise science, the facilities, the equipment, and indeed the staff base that we have really is quite exemplary. The basic underpinnings that we'd expect a student to have coming into the Masters are essentially from the undergraduate course that we have here at the University, but also that we would expect from any sport and exercise science undergraduate course, these being biomechanics, physiology and psychology. There are other topics that sort of orbit these main underlying topics, such as nutrition, motor control, those sort of things. We expect students to be able to have that foundation of understanding. The basic way the course then applies these foundation or fundamental principles is that we move straight into the idea of how do we assess the limits of performance? What are the limits of performance when we're considering either elite performance or perhaps lower level performance, depending on what the individual students, what part of the industry they're actually working with? The very first module we'll kick off with is a research methods module that has to be done in any science course. The following modules get into the laboratories essentially, look at assessing athletes using biomechanical, physiological and psychological assessment tools with an idea of understanding how we get our baseline for athletes' performance. Modules that follow on from that are about enhancing performance, how we actually take the basic understanding fundamental principles, how we assess athletes and understanding their limitations, how we then make them better essentially. And one of my personal modules is the enhancing performance module, where we take all this and then go and apply it in context to try and make athletes better. In addition to those sort of theoretical taught modules, if you like, there is a professional placement module where students are expected to either obtain or continue their employment they're currently doing with an academic mindset with regards to reflecting on that practice. And of course a dissertation module where they get to have a real stab at an independent study style piece of work, writing a dissertation at a master's level and presenting that back for assessment.